continues our coverage, speaking with drivers who do not want to wait. Jerry.
Well, tonight here at this rest stop in Orlando, we saw so many drivers heading up to North Florida, some heading home, others simply going to assist. This all happening as government agencies are urging drivers to stay off those impacted hurricane roads. As the Florida Panhandle is now covered in devastation after a deadly storm came through, I ran into Brian Duffy tonight here in Orlando. He owns a tree cutting business and is heading up north to assist storm survivors.
$5,000 out of my pocket.
Tomorrow morning, he's getting results and helping those in need, passing out free generators and bottled water in Tallahassee.
God sent us to do this, and me and my future wife are going up there to do this.
Now, despite state leaders urging evacuees to stay off the roads until given the all clear, folks like Duffy say the risk is all worth it.
We're going to make it. The Lord's with us.
And meet Roslyn Williams.
There is a curfew because we have no power, and they're saying that it's completely pitch black dark.
She lives near Tallahassee, and her story is like so many. Her home and her tax business are damaged.
All the trees are down. I have windows busted.
She knows the roads are dangerous, yet told me she had to make the drive home to make sure her family is okay.
I've called everybody that I know, and everyone's phones are off.
And we know tonight the American Red Cross and many churches have sent volunteers to Tallahassee to try and help those Hurricane Michael survivors bounce back. In Orange County, I'm Jerry Askin, News 6.